Hi friends, welcome back to React.js Zero to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about use context hook and how we can use that to avoid props drilling. In this video, I'm going to explain about how we can invoke HTTP request in React. Let's start. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It is a protocol used to access the data on the World Wide Web. In most of our applications, we get the data from backend. That means from some kind of database. We achieve this using HTTP. There are different types of requests we can do. They are get to get some data, post to create some new data, put to update some existing data, delete to remove some data. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can do a get request in React. And as part of advanced concept series, I'm going to create a separate video to cover all the CRUD operations. Okay, in frameworks like Angular, HTTP module is inbuilt. But React does not have any tools or objects or functions for making HTTP request. So we commonly use either Axios or Fetch to make request in React. Axios is a third-party HTTP client library for making request. We need to install that. Fetch is a promise-based built-in API. Hence, we don't have to install or import anything. When sending JavaScript objects to the API, Axios automatically stringifies data, but while using fetch, we need to serialize data into a JSON string. In Axios, the response data is available as a JSON by default. Hence, we can immediately access it using the data property. With fetch, there is one more step we have to take before accessing the response data. We need to convert it to JSON. Even though fetch API is a native interface with more possibilities than Axios, it can often be a little harder to use. And my personal preference is Axios. Okay, let me show you how we can use Axios and fetch in React. I have taken the code of the images and styles task solution. Here you can see all these data are hard-coded. And so you can see this. And I have also kept all these data in a table in MySQL and I have exposed an API using Node.js. The API is already up and running in port 5000. Okay, first let's use fetch to get the data. Like I told before, to use fetch, we don't want to install anything. Let me use an use effect which runs once on page load. Inside that, let me do fetch call. To this, I need to pass the URL. And as fetch is promise based, we can use the then callback to resolve that. So inside the then callback, let me print the response. We can see it is not in JSON. So we need to first convert that to JSON, like this. This is going to be another promise. And so let me resolve this also. And let me print this response now. We can see a data object here. So first, let me create a state to hold this data. And here, let me set the state. And here, let me comment all these hard-coded things. Now you will not see anything in the screen. Okay, let me use map to render all the characters. I can pass the respective props. Also, I need to add a key. I can use the ID for that. Now we can see our application is working, but this time we are getting data through HTTP. Okay, now let's see how we can use Axios. For that, first we need to install Axios. Let me quickly stop my server, install Axios and restart it. Okay, let me command this fetch call. And so we can see the data is not visible in the UI. To use Axios, first we need to import that from Axios. Now we can use Axios in our application. Let me create another use effect. And inside that, let me use Axios. We can use the get method from Axios. And for that, we can pass the same URL. This is also going to give us a promise. But if I resolve that promise, and if I console log the response, we can see it is already in JSON. so we can set the state directly. Like this. Now our application is working. Hope you understood how we can use fetch and Axios to invoke HTTP request in React. Okay, let me suggest you a task. You can create this small application. When you click any card, it should take you to the respective GitHub repo. To get the data, you can use this GitHub users API URL. For name, you can use the login parameter. For image, you can use this avatar URL. And for hyperlink URL, you can use this HTML URL. You can either use fetch or Axios. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can get it from this repo. The link is also available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.